Welcome back. This is Manjeet Raut from Bees and Technology. Guys, I'm just going to create this video related to the Amazon Web Services. You know that. And in this video, I'll try to give you more information related to the Amazon S3 bucket, right? In our last class, we are discussing about the S3 bucket and storage types, right? So now I'm just going to show more about the S3 bucket and like as a how many options, how many features are available in S3 bucket. So let's start. So to start work with S3 bucket, we need to open any browser and open Amazon site. I'm just going to log in the Amazon portal. Okay, so after logging the portal, our motto to start working with S3. Okay, I'm just going to log in it. And now just click on the services, and over our services, the second option related to the content is a S3 bucket, right? So we have already discussed about the S3 bucket in our previous classes, in previous video. So now I'm just going to show more option which is available in the property of S3 bucket. So I'm just going to create a one bucket, and the bucket just you need to click on the create and just type the bucket name. So you should be use the unique bucket name because it can work in worldwide. So I'm just going to put the name of bucket is demo training 1988. Okay, it's our bucket name, demo training 1988. Just click create. Fine, and just check it. The demo training bucket is created. Location in North Virginia, right? And we know that the bucket is a basically types of container that can contain the unlimited space. No need to pay anything, no need to pay any amount for the uploading the data. You need to pay only and only when you download the data or when you browse the data from bucket. So now I'm just going to show you the entire option which is available in the property of bucket, that you will be utilize your bucket for the organization purpose and for personal usage as well. So first of all, just open the bucket, and once we just open the bucket, it can give us a four different options: overview, properties, permissions and management, right? So I'm just going to show you, I'm just going to describe one by one. Like I'm just going to start from the overview. So under the overview, we have another four options: upload, create, download and action. So just click on the upload and select add, and it can give us an option. It can directly connect with your on premises machine, means it I'm talking about the local machine. So if you are just putting the data in your on premises, you can just select the data. I'm just going to upload one data in our bucket. Okay, so I'm just going to select this one. It's an image, it's a PNG image. I'm just going to upload it. Okay, now it's uploaded successfully, 100% succeeded. I'm just going to refresh. Now we are getting our data, right? And once you just click on the data, it can give us another option. Means we have a two different types of property. One is the bucket property, that is called container property. Another is data property, those data you are uploaded. So whenever we just click on the data, you will be get a various option like as open, download, download as, public and copy the path, right? So I'm just going to start discussion from the starting of usage of bucket data. So whenever we just click on the data, it can give us a number of options like as open, download, download as, make public and copy path. So as per the name, if you're talking about the open, so the meaning of open, it can just show you which data you are putting into the bucket. Like we are just putting in image in the bucket, so it can display the image in another wizard. Next one is the download. So download, it can download your data on the location of your downloading site, right? And next, download as. So the meaning of download as, you just download your data and put it into the your location where you want to download or where you want to put it. And next one is the make public. So actually we are using this particular option to make the data in public. Means you can just provide the option to access anyone your data by using this particular URL. Because I'm just going to check here. I'm just going to copy the URL and just try to paste on the any browser. Just paste. But unfortunately, we are unable to get the data, right? Because we are not making it in public. Because once you just make it public, you are able to access the data. But right now, by default, it's a block. I'm just going to click on the make public. Oh, it can just display access deny. Actually, it's a new feature added by the Amazon services before 2 months. Actually, it can give us a one more option added in the bucket property. I'm just going to show you why it is showing the deny, because you need to just allow the ACL. Open bucket, go to the permission, and under the permission, the first option is public access setting. And you just need to click edit. And once you just click edit, you just remove the entire option which is used for the policy. Save. Type here confirm. And click confirm again. Okay, we successfully save it. Just go to the browser again. Oh, sorry, overview again. Open the data property, make public. Now we are able to access the data because it can succeeded them to make the public. I'm just going to rephrase it. It's a encrypted format. Just rephrase. We are able to get our data, right? So this is the way. This is the base information related to the S3 bucket. We are just putting the data into the S3 bucket, open the data, go to the property, make our data into the public access, and copy the URL and paste into the any browser. And you can directly download, view, or browse your data directly with the help of URL, that URL given by the S3 bucket. Right? Now, I'm just going to discuss about the another option which is available in the bucket property. So just click on the bucket. This one is our bucket. We know that demo bucket 1988. And just click second option. The second option is property. So under the property, we have a number of options are available. Like as a versioning, like as a server access login, static website, object label logging, default encryption, various options are available, right? So I'm just going to describe one by one and step by step about the all. So firstly, I'm just going to start discussion with versioning, right? So if you're talking about the versioning option, so as per the name, the meaning of versioning is basically related to upload n number of data, n number of files with different version, and it can create only single file, and it can give us a number of version according to your uploading, according to your version type. I'm just going to show you one live practical. For example, you are just created a one file. I'm just going to create a one file with name of just type the I'm just going to create a one text file. Hello, how, sorry. Okay, I'm just going to type hello, how are you? This is one single file. I'm just going to go save it into the desktop and type the name of test. Okay, simple, just using the file name is test, and click save. Done. I'm just going to open the desktop, and this is our test file. If we just open the test file, hello, how are you? Okay, fine. I'm just going to close it, and turn on the versioning by using the property of S3 bucket. Click on enable versioning, save. Go to the overview again, upload your file, add, select your data. I'm talking about the file test. Okay, I'm not making any changes here. Click open and upload. We successfully uploaded one file with the name of test. And just open the file, make it public, and just try to see. I'm just going to click open, and it's just download one file. And if you are just open the file, it can display hello, how are you, right? Fine. I'm just going to open the file again, previous file, and just modify something. Like I just I am fine. What about you? Okay, just save. Control S. Done. I'm not making the any changes. I'm not changing the name of our file. Open the URL again, go to the bucket, overview, and upload again. Because you have already taken, make some changes in your existing file. Just upload. Okay, fine. So we successfully uploaded the same file without making any changes. So right now it can display only one file. It cannot be create another file because we have already enabled the versioning. I'm just going to check. Just click open it and just make it public. And I'm just try to open it again. Fine. One more file is downloaded. Just open. We are able to get the changes. But the meaning of versioning, for example, you just type the number of paragraphs, and after some days you can just make some changes, like you adding 4 or 5 paragraph more in the same existing bucket. You don't want to put it into the different files. You want to put the entire data in single file. So how you can recognize what's your previous data, what's your new data? So if you downloaded, if you uploaded the same file into the bucket, and under the bucket you have already enabled the versioning, then whenever you just open the bucket data, it can give us an option of latest version. I'm just going to click here. We have a two version, latest version, old version, right? The latest version is uploaded 1150 and old version uploaded 1149. I'm just going to click on the old version and just try to open it again and just try to see what exactly changes. Fine, we are able to get our old data. So that is the task of our versioning. It's a first work, it's a first result of versioning. But by using the versioning option, you can also make a replica. We will also discuss about the replication of bucket data. We will be move our entire data from one location to another location. But before it, we just try to understand about the properties option, which is available in the S3 bucket. I hope you understand about the meaning of versioning, right? So in the single word, we can say that the versioning is one of important option which is available in S3 bucket. By using the S3 bucket versioning, you can put the number of file without making any without changing the file name, and you will be get the entire changes that you did with your file. Next option is server access login. So as per the name of server access login, set up access log record that provide detail about the access request. Actually, if you're talking about the login access, so it is just types of container, means your bucket will be container and put the entire logs. Those logs are generated by the server, right? So if you want to put the logs detail into the bucket, you need to configure the server access login as well. Okay, in our next video, we'll describe on the type or on the part of server access login. We will be manage the entire practical and give you the live information. And next one is the static website hosting. So as per the name, static website hosting, in the sense you are just planning to host your website, and your website is designed with the help of HTML and .NET, and you are just making the entire hyperlink with single file. So the best option to deploy your static website by using the static website hosting option. Okay, so I'm just going to click on the overview, and under the overview, just try to upload my one of local website. So I have my one local website. I'm just going to show you. I'm just going to click on the index.html. See, this is our local website, right? That created with the help of .NET and HTML, right? So I'm just going to upload this particular file into our S3 bucket. Simple. I'm just going to click on the upload, click on the add file. Under the add file, desktop, where is our data? It's available in website data. Okay, and select your hyperlink file. So hyperlink file is index.html. Just click on the index.html, click open and click upload. Fine. Just once your file is uploaded, you just need to go to the bucket properties again, and under the bucket property, go to the static website, click first one, use this bucket to host website and type here index.html. And once you just type the index.html, just click save. Now your bucket is ready to host your static website. Just click here, copy the URL that given by the, you can also say that it's kind of endpoint, and you just use this particular endpoint to host your website to get the result of your data. Unfortunately, it can give us the information related 403 error. So we know that the 403 error is related to the not accessing the data. I'm just going to copy the entire file, entire website, okay, and try it again. Unable to get it, because you know that we are not making the public. You should be make the public. Just click on data, go to the make public and try again. Okay, because once you just upload your data, it is a denial. No one can access from the public. Now we are able to see our website that we uploaded into the bucket. So with the help of S3 bucket, we are also able to deploy our website, deploy our static website. So no, I know it's just display the half image of our website, because I'm just uploading only single data, only single file in the bucket. If you want to see the entire information, you just use a hyperlink and hyperlink the entire image and files with your single file, and just upload the entire file into the bucket and make it public. Okay, so this is the information related to the second part is deploying a static website hosting, right? And third one is related to the object label login. So right now we have a two different options related to each other, like as a server access login and object label login. So object label login is related, it can perform the same task like as a server access login, but it is responsible to contain the logs related to entire activity that happen over a portal. Means actually it is uses one of important service called CloudTrail. So what exactly work of CloudTrail? Basically the CloudTrail is a service that can use to contain the information related to our activity. Means if you are creating a S3 bucket, you are creating a instances, you are creating the databases, so entire information automatically feed into the CloudTrail. I'm just going to show you the work of CloudTrail. So in the management part, one option is available called CloudTrail. By default, the Amazon Web Services can give you to use your CloudTrail services, but you will be get only 90 days old data. If you are organization, if you are running your in organization and you purchased number of services from the portal, so CloudTrail is really helpful to get the entire logs. So actually the option of object label login and CloudTrail both are working with each other. If you are just login the object label login, and you can choose the CloudTrail. Right now we are not creating any CloudTrail. Means you just associate your S3 bucket with CloudTrail service, right? Why we need to do that? Because the CloudTrail is just monitor the activity, and S3 bucket is contain the activity. We can say that CloudTrail is a mediator and S3 is the container. CloudTrail is generate the logs, and S3 bucket can contain the logs, right? So if you want to know much more about your activity over a portal, so you should be use this particular services. It's really helpful. to monitor and manage the logs related activity. Okay, so this is the info related to the object label login. Next one is the encryption. So as per the name, encryption is the kinds of security, means if you don't want to share any data with public or any other user, you can just encrypt your data. I'm just going to show you. There are encryption is available in two part. One is Amazon Encryption Services 256 and Amazon Key Management Services. Okay, so I'm just going to use the KMS, Key Management Service, and select the key. It can give us a default key, one with the name of ARN and another is AWS/S3. You can also create your custom ARN, but I'm going to make it AWS/S3 and click save. Now you successfully activated your encryption over the bucket. I'm just going to show you the result. Just click on the overview and select your data. Like I'm just going to select our data, like as that put it into the bucket. Just click on the test page and go to the property again. And the one more option is also available here, that is called encryption. You can just click encryption and use the same encryption method in the bucket and save. Now our data is successfully saved, our data is successfully encrypted, and now you can just make it and copy that URL and try to access it. We are unable to get it, right? Because you are just encrypt your entire data. Those data are available in your bucket. So meaning of encryption, you can say that you don't want to make our data public. If you have already make it public and you don't want to give the access of anyone who taken your public URL, you just go to the property of bucket as well as property of your data and just click on the property, select the encryption, encrypt the data, right? Okay, next, another option is also available here, like as the object log, tag, accelerate, transfer, acceleration, events, and requester page. So actually these are the complements that given by the Amazon Web Services. And if we're talking about the work of object logs, so it can give us an option. If you are just enable the object log, no one can delete your bucket. But means you can just say that prevent the data from deletion. If you are putting any data, if you are putting any data in your bucket and you don't want to anyone delete it, you just secure your data by using the object log option. And next one is the tagging. So as per the name of tags, use tag to track your cost against project or other criteria. So tags is really important option which is available in most of services of Amazon, because with the help of this particular service you can trace services, resources, and you can also manage the part of your costing. Next, transfer acceleration. It's a service which is available in the property of S3 bucket. And by using this particular service, if you are enabled the transfer acceleration, it means that you want to increase the speed of your bucket. Means speed of your data transmission, those data you are putting into the under the bucket. And one more thing, you need to pay extra amount if you are just enabling the transfer acceleration. Is it okay? Next one is the events. So as per the name, events is related to the activity. If any events are generated, you will be get information in the part of events, like as a notification or any another events are occurred with your bucket. Last one is the requester page. So the meaning of requester page, for example, you are uploading some data under your bucket and another account says I just need to access your data. And your bucket data size is too much, like as up to 500 GB, and another guy is want to download the entire 500 GB. So if you are enable the requester pay, no need to pay any amount for the downloading and browsing. Only the requester can pay. It's a really latest option and really important option. Means payment given by the requester, not by the owner. So this is the information related to the bucket and bucket's property. I hope you understand about the activity of S3 bucket, and you can utilize the S3 bucket for the various purpose, like we have already discussed about the various purpose, like as you can share the data, you can use the bucket with CloudFront, CloudTrail, deploy in the website, static website, in the migration part it can also help you. So this is the basic information related to the bucket. So I hope you understand about the activity of bucket. So thank you so much for watching, and we'll create another video related to the EFS, right? Because the EFS is also a part of storage services. So in next video we'll discuss about the EFS, Elastic File System. Okay, thank you so much for watching.